General David Mohoz, the Minister of State for Internal Affairs, told Parliamentary Plenary on Thursday that government will issue smart digital IDs capturing people's DNA going forward once the current version expires.
NIRA seeks to take advantage of the strides in technology that will increase portability and verification to support global transactions. If Uganda has porous borders and is yet to attain 100% birth and death registration, the exercise will improve accuracy and credibility of the register for planning and improved service.
The Parliamentary Committee of Defence and Internal Affairs, chaired by Rosemary, the Shema District Woman MP, have endorsed the move as another way to curb criminality in the country.
The DNA bank has been pending for so long, and actually money has been given to DIGAL to construct the DNA bank for a period of I think about 3 years now, and the challenge has been acquiring the land title for where they are going to construct the DNA bank. However, they secured everything, and remember, we are in the rollout of the national identity cards. So that DNA bank is going to back up the national identity cards, because the national identity cards will be having a feature for the DNA, such that wherever you are going, that identity card is directly linked to you yourself as an individual. It is a very good policy, and we think that when it comes up, it is going even to help police to fight crimes. It is going to help the country in terms of tracking who has done what, even in terms of forensic. This is something that is very good. And as a ministry, the minister promised to come up with a policy that is going to back up the DNA bank. And for us as a committee, of course, we support it. It is welcome, and we believe it is going to help the country.
The committee has recommended Parliament to allocate the Directorate of Government Analytic Laboratory 25 billion shillings in the next financial year to construct the National DNA Bank that will help NIRA to incorporate DNA information on national IDs.
The new cards to roll out, and even the fresh ones that will be given, they should be having that feature, rather than costing government another money once we roll out with the DNA to do it again.
However, opposition members of parliament have questioned the move, saying they have no guarantee of safety of DNA information in hands of government.
Well, we have seen state operatives planting and stage managing opposition members, even businessmen, and they have come out to allege them on different cases. We believe the same government can use the same DNA to manipulate, or probably to state manage cases on opposition members.
It identified with the human rights violation in this country. We need a proper entity to be in charge of people's secrets, if any. Otherwise, they might manufacture evidence against the people using such data and place it on scenes of crime, among others. This is a worry.
Others have called the development as an encroachment to the citizens' right of privacy. They wondered why government does not settle for fingerprints, which are used worldwide.
We are here, we have a law about privacy. Now, how are you going to get my blood to go and keep it there, when actually we are not trusting these people with our privacy already, what we have submitted to them? So we need to go and maybe interrogate those policies and laws, so that we can create an environment which will favor them to do that work.
We pointed out those key issues, the loopholes within the whole procedure of renewal of IDs. First and foremost, we believe that Ugandans are Ugandans, and we cannot aspire to be Ugandans. Consequently, we cannot have expiring ID books. I don't know how they are doing it, because they are quoting a legislation from ROPA. And now that legislation is totally inconsistent with the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda.
A couple of legislators have welcomed DNA proposal, saying it's going to close gaps in security systems which have been exploited by criminals to wreak havoc.
I think that is good, because to a national ID is your personal identification, and it will improve our security. So that if I present my national ID, that is me, I cannot deny.
It's not that it is going to be started in here. We are a long way back behind. Other modern countries started this long time ago, and it's the way to go given the criminality in the world that we see in the societies.
The National Identification and Registration Authority, NIRA, began issuing national IDs in 2004, and the first batch expires in 2024 because each is valid for only 10 years. This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News in Parliament.